हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम फ्रेंड्स। टुडे आई टीच कंजर्वेशन ऑफ लीनियर मोमेंटम। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल नाउ वी सी वन एग्जांपल। फ्रेंड्स, यहाँ पर देखिए, हमारे पास एक गन है और उसमें एक बुलेट भी है। इनिशियली बोथ आर स्टेडी, मीन्स टोटल मोमेंटम ऑफ द सिस्टम इज इनिशियली ज़ीरो। ओके, यहाँ पे हम जब फायर करते हैं तब बुलेट आगे जाती है और जो हमारा गन है वो बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन में मूव होता है। मीन्स द फोर्स ऑफ बुलेट and the force of gun both are equal but both are in opposite direction। जो ये ब्लू वाला दिखाई दे रहा है, अभी दिखाई देगा, वो हमारा बुलेट का डायरेक्शन है और ये येल्लो वाला है जो वो गन हमारा है वो पीछे जा रहा है। इनिशियली मोमेंटम इज ज़ीरो एंड फाइनली आफ्टर फायरिंग मोमेंटम इज ऑल्सो ज़ीरो, मीन्स मोमेंटम इज कंजर्व। हियर FBG मीन्स फोर्स अप्लाई ऑन बुलेट ड्यू टू बाय गन एंड FGB फोर्स अप्लाई ऑन गन due to by bullet, both are equal and both are in opposite direction। So now we take here minus sign। Look here, when bullet is fired from the gun, bullet moves in forward direction and gun moves in backward direction। The force applied by gun on bullet be F, then the force applied bullet on the gun be minus F because direction is opposite। These two force act on equal time interval delta t। So by second law of motion, change in momentum of bullet means F delta t, and change in momentum of the rifle is equal to minus F delta T। Initially both are at rest, hence change in momentum of body equal to final momentum। Let final momentum of the gun is PG and bullet is PB। So we can write down here PG is equal to minus PB। This PB is move left hand side, so we get PG plus PB is equal to 0. Thus the total linear momentum of the system is conserved, and law of the conservation of momentum is for isolated system total linear momentum of the system remain constant। Friends, here now we show another example। Consider now we have two objects A and B, and their initial momentum is PA and PB, but let after collision their momentum is PA dash and P dash B। By the second law of motion, change in momentum means impulse of force FAB is delta D is equal to, we can write down change in momentum means final momentum minus initial momentum, means final momentum is a P dash A and initial momentum is a PA। Same way FBA delta T is equal to P dash B minus PB, here dash is by mistake, it is not required, Again, this formula is P dash B minus PB. So from Newton's third law of motion, we can write down FAB is equal to minus FBA. An impulse of force FAB delta T is equal to minus FBA delta T. Here FAB delta T and FBA delta T, both are value are available and substitute here. So instead FAB delta T, we can write down P dash A minus PA. And instead FBA delta T, we can write down P dash B minus PB. So here minus sign are multiplied. So P dash B is a minus. This term is moved left hand side. So we get P dash A plus P dash B. And this minus PA is moved right hand side. So it is converted into plus. So we get PA plus PB. Thus, for isolated system, the total final momentum is equal to total initial momentum. Here both elastic or non-elastic collision momentum is conserved. But the elastic collision, both momentum and kinetic energy is conserved. So law of conservation of linear momentum is universal and fundamental. Its quality hold true of system of small particle like electron, proton, neutron, as well as large system made up of electron, proton and neutron. And our next question is, what are co-current force? Explain equilibrium of particle under effect of co-concurrent force. Here concurrent force, if line is action of all given force pass through same point, then these force are called concurrent force. First of all, now we show video. Look here, this figure. Here now we have one particle. And now we have two forces are applied. Here F1 in this direction and F2 in this direction. Both forces are equal. But both are in opposite direction. So total force at one particle is zero. So this type of force is non concurrent forces. Same way, look here. Here now we have three forces are applied on this particle. Suppose F2 and F3 is 50-50, means 50 plus 50 means 100, and F1 force is 100 Newton. So this particle is also remains steady because total force is zero. Same way here, F2 and F4, F1 and F3 are equal and they are opposite direction. So total force of this particle is zero. So this type of force are known as co-current forces. In mechanical, when resultant force acting on particle is zero, then the particle is said to be in equilibrium. In this case, particle is either stationary or moving with constant velocity. If only one force F act on particle, then it has accelerated motion. it cannot remain be equilibrium. If force F1 and F2 act on particle, then for equilibrium summation F is equal to 0. Means, we can say that F1 plus F2 is equal to 0. Means, F1 is equal to minus F2. Look this sphere, and suppose on one particle here, three types of force F1, F2 and F3 act on a particle. Then for equilibrium, summation F is equal to 0. Means F1 plus F2 plus F3 is equal to 0. So F3 is equal to F1 and F2 move right hand side. They are converting negative. Then the represented in diagram so below. By parallelogram law of force, resultant force of F1 and F2 is represented by diagonal. When force F3 equal to same magnitude is applied on opposite direction, particle will be in equilibrium. Means PQ plus QR plus RP is equal to 0. Means F1 plus F2 plus F3 is equal to 0. Means summation F is equal to 0. In generally, from if F1, F2, F3 and S FN be force acting on particle. So, total force F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus FN is equal to 0. Then the for equilibrium means summation F is equal to 0. Means all this force equal to 0. Friends, all this formula we can also write down in component X, Y and Z. Here all formula are available. And our next example, our question is, see figure, a mass of 6 kg is suspended by a rope of length 2 meter from the ceiling. A force of 50 newton in the horizontal direction is applied at the midpoint P of the rope, as so. So, what is the angle of rope make with the vertical in equilibrium? Neglect the mass of the rope. Friends, first of all, look this figure. Here W is a weight. Weight, its formula is mg. Mg is in downward direction. And T for tension force of the rope. It is in upward direction. So, T2 is equal to mg. Here m is equal to 6 kg and g is equal to gravitational acceleration. Its real value is 9.8. But here, now we take, its value is 10. So, T2 is equal to 60 newton. Well, look this figure. Here T2 is downward direction and T1 have two components. T1 x cos theta and T1 sin theta. Here T1 cos theta is opposite of T2 and T1 sin theta is opposite its 50 newton. So from this figure we can write down T1 cos theta is equal to T2 for equilibrium, means T2 cos theta is equal to 60. And from figure T1 sin theta is equal to 50. So, this equation number 1 and this equation number, suppose here 1 and this is 2. So, 2 divided by 1. So, we get T1 sin theta upon T2 cos theta is equal to 5 upon 6. Here T1 and T2 both are same, means both are cut. Sin upon cos 10 theta and 5 upon 6 is equal to 0.8333. With the help of natural tangent, we can find out the degree for this value. We get 39 degree and 48 minute. Means similarly we can write down 40 degree. We see that the resultant do not depend on the length of the rope or position of the horizontal force. Friends, today's question you write in your notebook and prepare it. Thank you.